Alright guys, this is going to be my first battle in the Agony 1v1 Championship, and you know what this means. I have been eliminated from the tournament. Finally! I'm just glad I made it as far as I did. I'm going to be posting all my replays, losses, wins, everything, the shamanimo, everything. And this is going to be my first opponent, Ron Dominic. He's a very high level player, but he mostly plays Shogun 2 avatars, so I don't think he liked Fall of Samurai avatars at all. He's very high on the leaderboards, but if he got on the leaderboards because he plays Shogun 2 avatars, then the edge is mine in this matchup because I have more experience with Fall of Samurai avatars while he has more experience with Shogun 2. So I'm sure if we played with Shogun 2 avatars, he would destroy me because he loves them. For my build, I'm going to bring, so far, Spear Levy, Black Tortoise Force Vanilla. Looks like it's going to be three Black Tortoise Force Vanilla, a bunch of Spears, Tamakachi, Spear Levy, Black Tortoise Force, and a lot of these units are Vanilla. I don't know what I was thinking. Shogatai, level 3. Spear Levy, Vanilla, Shogatai, level 2. Black Tortoise, Vanilla, Shogatai, rank 2. Spear Levy, Vanilla. But I put most of my upgrades on my Cav. I have 4 Cav units, I think, so far, from what I can see. I have 4 Yeri Ki, and one is level 5, another is level 4, one is rank 5, and this last one is rank 4. I'm going to go for the farmhouse. I'm going to try and move up to go and secure the archery dojo, just to make sure he doesn't get it, because he does have guns. I have guns as well, but not as strong as him. He does have 1 Imperial Infantry, rank 3. 3 French Marine, rank 5, just to get the 150 range upgrade. So it's a typical, well-upgraded unit. That's the cost-efficient French Marine. He does have a Shogatai, looks like they are Vanilla. Tamakachi, Vanilla. Vermilion Bird Force. All these banners are mixed up, so I can't exactly see their ranking. Here it is. Rank 3, he does have a level 6... Looks like a Bushido Jun, because I do see second win. And a Black Bear, rank 3. And another Black Bear, rank 2. And he does have a few Cav. He does have 3 Yeri Ki. One has rank 5. One has rank 4. Another is Vanilla. But he does have Practice Ground, so that gives him plus 2 melee attack, giving him 12 melee. And he does have 1 Parrot Guns. If I had to choose between Parrot Guns or Armstrong Guns, I would definitely go for Armstrong Guns. I just feel like they're more cost-efficient, since they get better accuracy and reload. And the accuracy ability really does... I guess if you use the accuracy ability much more than just keeping your unit on fire at will and target specific units, instead of just letting them shoot whatever, letting the AI take over and shoot whatever, your unit will be more cost-efficient. Just use accuracy and shoot the more powerful units, like... See right here, he's trying to shoot my Shogatai. That's the best choice because that's the only punching power I have in my force. Other than that, I have my Cav. I'm going to split up my Cav forces. Split up my guns as well, just so if he turns to face my melee and my... It's just a mixed flanking force over here, just to hammer his force from the side. And if he turns, I can shoot him from the side over here. And I have a Spirit Levy, 2 Spirit Levy over here, just in case he takes his Cav to attack. So my assault is going to be quite organized, but it's going to turn out to be disorganized later on, because he's going to do that by setting up his Shogatai to just hold down and pin my melee forces and my guns. He's going to take some nice shots. He is going to use, looks like Rally. That's kind of a waste, because none of his units were in melee or nothing, so that's a waste of a Rally. He is going to send some Cav now. It looks like he sees that my Cav are starting to maneuver, try and get some flanking done, but this Cav unit is just going to be decimated from all sides and the back by Spear Levy. But it's a good job though, because with one unit, he actually blobbed up all of mine, and now he's going to get off a nice little charge on the side and everything. He's going to shoot into the blob with his guns. So he's doing a good thing. It's like, at first, I was really organized, but now he disorganized my entire force with his Cav. He sent up his Katamakaji in melee against my guns. I wasn't watching this. So, very bad micro on my part. It looks like he was trying to just organize a little bit, try and run away his troops. At first, he could have won this Cav engagement if his guns kept on supporting, but good thing my melee were still persistent in their assault, because because that drew his guns to run away, and one of them is routing at 147. That is bad. Wow, only 3 casualties done for them, and they're already routed. So a lot of his units are running now. I mean, I bet if his melee were just in melee and he dropped down that rally on him, he would have pinned down my forces even further, and his guns would have done the support that they needed to help in the melee fight and in the cabin fight. So it looks like just I had too many units for him to pin down. My melee broke through, I had better melee and more melee, and now my cav are, now my force is just more organized than it was initially, because he really did disorganize it a bit, but he didn't really get the full use out of his guns. Now I have to say, I'm the only one to face my opponent, Dominic, because after I faced him twice, I'll show you the second and last match between us, and I'll explain after that, actually. It would be kind of bad to spoil it. So I'm just going to take my cav and go after his last unit over here. He does have another unit over here, his Black Bear, but he does have another one right here, and they're rank 4. I didn't see them earlier. Maybe he had them trying to go for the workshop, I think. I don't know. Maybe they came back from routing. Maybe that was the one that came back from routing when... Oh, no, 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 because this was the one. Okay, that was a costly victory. I'm going to end it there so we can go to the results screen. I'm going to show you the unit statistics. I don't usually show that much, but it would be nice to just show that for once, because a lot of people do want to see that. I know a lot of people message me saying, hey, you need to at least show the unit statistics. Your observation is good, but people just want to see what did the most damage to your enemy's army. Like, what did you use? So there we go. I deployed a lot. I lost a lot as well. I killed a decent amount, not as much as I lost, but... it's okay, it's okay, that's what the numbers are for. Just, it's an attritional way of defeating your opponent, kind of like what Napoleon wanted to do against Wellington at the Battle of Waterloo. He wanted to make a frontal attack against him, and he figured a larger army, which he had at the moment, before the Prussians reinforced the Anglo-Dutch army under Wellington, he thought he could pull an attritional aggression against them, but... here's his force, it's decently sized, he did lose and kill a decent amount. Here's the unit statistics. Now the kills, you can see my Shugatai, of course, and my other melee are going to be doing that thing. They need to. That's what swords are there for. Now, as I go down, oh, this Shugatai didn't kill that much at all. It lost almost half. Spear levies, they're meat shields anyway, they're supposed to be doing their job, so... when you see your Shogatai and guns and your cav did enough and your spear levy didn't, then you know that your spear levies did their job as a meat shield to protect and absorb volleys of shots, and I brought 5 spear levy. This one, yeah, they didn't kill that much at all. But in my next matches, you'll see how much Shogatai, cav, and spear levy can potentially kill, how much they might be able to kill at their max. Alright, so that's the end of this first match, on to the second one.